Hello everyone and welcome to EduCert Small Talk series where we discuss some common topics related to our practice. Today's topic is a topic suggested by one of our viewers. So thank you for your suggestion. It's a very interesting topic and I hope you all enjoy it as well. And it is based on pancreas protocol CT. So what we are going to do in this video is we are going to discuss why a protocol CT is important, how this pancreas protocol CT is done. So we will go into some basics of the CT scan acquisition, reconstruction, as well as image processing. We will then discuss what is seen in the pancreas protocol CT and when, that is in which phase the pancreas protocol can show different findings and where to look for these findings. So these are going to be our points of discussion in this video, and we will also see some practical cases that I have managed in my team to highlight why a pancreas protocol CT is important. So we will also be diving into the console towards the later part of this video. So before going into this topic, just 30 seconds into a very practical point that we have learned from our teachers and that we follow. So just an anecdotal example, as you can see here in black and white, these two people seem to be enjoying their company. However, actually it is not so. So what we always see in shadow may not be actually true, right? This is just an example to bring forward the point that it is very important to have a discussion in teams so that the black and white images of the scans are correlated clinically. We always see these words in the report. However, both teams need to discuss with each other so as to actually know what the findings mean, because the black and white images by themselves cannot give you a diagnosis. So in this video, we are going to see basic CT scan terminology. We are going to see why we need a pancreas protocol CT, basics of pancreas protocol and interpretation, and lastly, we are going to see some case scenarios of pancreas protocol CT, different phases and when we can see different structures. So CT scan process requires three major steps. The first is image acquisition, that is when the patient lies down on the machine and the image is acquired. The second is image reconstruction and processing, that is the image is reconstructed differently or processed in different reformations to give us the final image which comes on the image display in grayscale. We all know the grayscale, where the bone is white or has the highest value and air has the most negative value. And all the structures in the pancreas protocol CT fall between the white of bone and the black of air. That is the grayscale. So when we say CT pancreas protocol, it is a protocol CT for solid organs. And now what is the basic of protocol is that it involves different timed phases. That is, it has scan acquisition at different times. What are these times? These times are based on the IV contrast reaching a particular structure. And it has different post-processing options. So that is how a protocol CT for any solid organ is based. As we all know, commonly we have protocol CTs for liver and pancreas. So CT pancreas protocol image acquisition, we need to see what are the contrast related factors and the timing related factors. We need to see how the image is reconstructed and image display is between bone and air. Now let us see these two factors in details which are important during the image acquisition to plan a pancreas protocol CT. The first factor is contrast related factors. So as we all know, there is oral contrast and intravenous contrast. If not, I'm going to cover them in a very basic video on CT. So you can stay tuned for that. So for CT pancreas protocol, the oral contrast usually is negative, and most commonly used negative oral contrast is water. This helps in distending the stomach and duodenum. Because as we know, pancreas is intimately related to the C loop of duodenum. So if we distend that loop, it is going to help. And also negative oral contrast gives a better contrast between the bowel and the pancreas. So that is why negative oral contrast is used in pancreas protocol CP. Regarding IV contrast, there are some important points. The volume of IV contrast used is usually 1.5 to 1.8 ml per kilogram. And it is given at the rate of 2 to 5 ml per second. Newer techniques and consoles use bolus tracking with threshold at the abdominal aorta above the pancreas. So bolus tracking can be used, and the threshold is set as 50 to 100 Hounsfield units. Bolus tracking helps to start the scan appropriately for different phases in the protocol CT. And it can be done with or without a saline chaser using a dual injector. Now, these are some simple machines. What bolus tracking does it? We put a point on the region of interest. The region of interest for pancreas protocol CT is abdominal aorta above the pancreas. And we set a threshold enhancement value. So when the contrast produces 50 to 100 Hounsfield unit enhancement at abdominal aorta above the pancreas, that is when the timer will start, and that is when the different phases will be acquired. What is bolus tracking and saline chaser? It is just a machine which connects to the intravenous line of the patient. Saline chaser or dual injector requires two different canisters. One contains the saline, one contains the contrast. Once the contrast goes in the IV line, the saline is pushed so as to clear the contrast of the peripheral line faster and reach the threshold quicker. It increases the concentration of the contrast in the desired structures, and it reduces the dose that is required. So that is bolus tracking with or without saline chase. So these are some of the contrast related factors. And as I have already discussed, they help in doing the pancreas protocol CT. The next point is timing. That is, which phase is taken and where will the contrast be at that phase. So the first phase is non-contrast phase, that is a plain CT scan or a pre-contrast imaging. So in this, the IV contrast has not been used, only the negative oral contrast has been given. Next is the early arterial phase. Now this usually is not done in a pancreas protocol CT unless you are suspecting a neuroendocrine neoplasm or you are suspecting an arterial pseudoaneurysm or aneurysm. That is when you need to see this phase. So again, the importance of discussing the case with the clinician and deciding which phases are required. So if early arterial phase is done, it shows contrast predominantly in the arteries and can give an arteriogram by post-processing software. The next is a delayed arterial phase or a pancreatic parenchymal phase. So in this phase, you can see a bit of contrast in the portal vein, but you will not see contrast in the IVC or the hepatic veins. So delayed arterial phase, when the arteries are nicely visible, the pancreas is enhancing well, you can see blood on contrast filling up in the portal vein, but you can't see the contrast in the hepatic veins. That is the delayed arterial phase. So as you can see, these phases are named just on the position of contrast in different structures during different phases. Early arterial phase, it is predominantly in the arterial circulation. Delayed arterial phase, when it starts going into the portal circulation, but not into the IVC or the venous circulation. The last is the portal venous phase, when the contrast is predominantly in the portal system and it just about begins to appear in the hepatic veins and the IVC. So that is how these phases are decided. In the liver protocol CT, you also do a delayed phase imaging, and this is predominantly for cholangiocarcinomas. So this is the basis of different phases used in different protocol CTs. And based on the contrast in these structures, the enhancement pattern of the organs also differs. Usually the liver and the pancreas, the parenchymal enhancement is very good in the delayed arterial phase, whereas the pancreatic tumors and its relation to superior mesenteric vessels are better seen in the portal venous phase. The delayed phase is used predominantly in the liver protocol CT scan, as there are tumors like cholangiocarcinoma which enhance well in the delayed phase due to its intense fibrogenic property. So this is how these phases are used in different protocols. So now coming back to CT pancreas protocol, and now you know that the CT acquisition timing is what helps us in defining the protocol. So the different phases that are used in CT pancreas protocol are non-contrast phase, or the plain CT scan, or the pre-contrast CT, which is done at 0 seconds. Next is the early arterial phase, which I have described, can be skipped if you are not looking for neuroendocrine neoplasms or vascular aneurysms. Early arterial phase is not routinely done as a part of pancreas protocol. The routine phases are non-contrast phase, the pancreatic parenchymal phase or the delayed arterial phase, and the portal venous phase. So these three phases are usually used in the pancreatic protocol, but the early arterial phase can also be used. The scan delay for early arterial phase is 15 seconds, and this is standard delay when bolus tracking and saline chase is not used. 15 seconds for early arterial phase, 35 to 45 seconds for the delayed arterial phase, and 60 to 70 seconds for the portal venous phase. Now, if you have seen our Facebook page, I have already described the book that we refer to for gastrointestinal and hepatopancreaticobiliary radiology, that is the textbook of gastrointestinal radiology by Gore and Levin. So these timings are based on the literature from Gore and Levin as well as from our liver and pancreas textbook. However, the timings may vary slightly as per different books, but predominantly these are the phases. If you are using bolus tracking and saline chase, as I have already discussed, the threshold of 50 to 100 Hounsfield units at abdominal aorta above the pancreas, then the timing of acquisition reduces. And in this, the early arterial phase starts at 8 seconds, delayed arterial phase starts at 25 seconds, and the portal venous phase starts at 50 seconds. So this is the reduction in time that you get with bolus tracking. So what do we see, when do we see, and where do we see? Now that is the part of the presentation that is remaining, and then we will see some of the examples on the CT console. So first is the pre-contrast phase in the pancreas protocol, then is the pancreatic parenchymal phase or the delayed arterial phase, and then is the portal venous phase. So these are the standard phases that we use. In the pre-contrast phase or the plain scan, what we look for is the calcification. As you all know, we can have calcification in chronic pancreatitis, which can be ductal calcification or parenchymal calcification. And you can have stones in the common bile duct or gallbladder, which may be calcified and seen on the plain scan. So predominantly we see calcification in the vessels, in the pancreas, and in the common bile duct and gallbladder in the plain phase. Delayed arterial phase or pancreatic parenchymal phase is when we see the enhancement of the pancreatic parenchyma. Also, what you can see in the delayed arterial phase, as I have said, that you see the contrast in the arteries as well as beginning of contrast in the portal vasculature. So you can see relation of these tumors briefly with the arteries in this phase. Also, the enhancement pattern of the parenchyma helps in different cases such as acute pancreatitis and pancreatic necrosis. So that is also well seen in this phase as well as in the portal venous phase. Predominantly, it is the portal venous phase which is the most important phase when we are doing the pancreatic protocol CT. As if you are doing a tumor scan, you can see the lymph nodes, the liver metastasis, as well as properly define the relation of lesion to the superior mesenteric and the portal vein structures. So these are predominantly the findings that you can identify as per the different phases. This is a very basic talk when we will see these scans in detail for acute pancreatitis as well as chronic pancreatitis and pancreatic tumors in subsequent radiology talks. We will elaborate on the findings that you can have in the different phases. These are just the very common and the most essential findings that you need to know in different phases of the CT pancreas protocol. Apart from this, you can have an early arterial phase, as I've already discussed, which is an arteriogram. So as we have discussed the timings also, pre-contrast phase is at 0 seconds. Delayed arterial phase or the pancreatic parenchymal phase is at 35 to 45 seconds without bolus tracking, and portal venous phase is at 60 to 70 seconds without bolus tracking and at 50 seconds with bolus tracking. So that is the CT pancreas protocol summarized in a single slide for you. Now we will dive into our console and see some common findings in the pancreas protocol CT that we have had. So let us dive into the CT console. So welcome to the CT console. This is the first phase of the pancreas protocol, that is the non-contrast or the pre-contrast CT scan or the plain CT scan. Why this is a CT scan? Just the very basics, because the bone is white. As you can see, the ribs, the vertebra, these structures are white, so this is a CT scan. This is a plain image. As we have already discussed, if you have not seen the video, you can see the video on the basics of the CT anatomy that we have put before. Here the aorta is not as white as the vertebra, nor is the cava as white as the vertebra. So this is a plain scan, right? This is the vena cava. So this is a plain scan. Now, as I have said, the first phase of a CT pancreas protocol is the plain CT or the pre-contrast or the non-contrast CT. And predominantly what you can see in this phase as far as pancreas is concerned is the calcification. So this is one of the cases that we manage for chronic pancreatitis. And as you can see, these white dots, these are the stones in the pancreas, right? This is the pancreas. Again, if you are finding it difficult to identify the organs, you can see one of our videos on basics of CT anatomy. I will share the link in the description so you can see that video. So in the pancreas, you can see these white dots. This is the calcification. Again, you can see some very predominant parenchymal calcifications. You can see a stone in the pancreatic duct as I move up and down, right? This black portion is the pancreatic duct. So you can see a stone in the pancreatic duct. This is the dilated pancreatic duct, right? We'll see the duct later in the parenchymal phase when the parenchyma enhances. Because in this, I can identify the duct, but for basic purposes, all you need to see in the plain scan is the calcification. So you can see here multiple white dots. These are all stones in the pancreas, and this is a classic finding of chronic pancreatitis. So now going with the same case, as I told you, the different phases of the pancreatic protocol, I will just highlight why these phases are important now. So as you can see in this video now, you can see two different cuts on the console, and this is the benefit of viewing the scan on the console. You can see different phases together or simultaneously, and you have, if you have synchronized your console, you can see same structures in both these cuts together, right? So this is why the different phases can be viewed on the console with your radiologist, and that will make your scan viewing very easy. So we had seen the plain phase of this patient, and now you have the delayed arterial phase as well as the portal phase, and I will just highlight which one is which. I am sure most of you now know which is the delayed arterial or the pancreatic parenchymal phase and the portal venous phase out of these two. So just the common structures that you have already seen, this is the aorta, right? So on the left panel where my cursor is, the aorta is white, whereas on the right panel it is not as white. Okay, point number one. As I go a bit up and down, you can see that the arteries arising from the aorta are also white here, whereas they are not as white on this side, right? The third point is you can see the portal vein very faintly here, but the portal vein is very well opacified here, right? The basis for explaining all this is that this is the delayed arterial phase where you can see the arteries nicely, right? This is the superior mesenteric artery, so you can see the arteries nicely, but the portal vein is just about forming, right? The portal vein is just about forming. So this is the delayed arterial or the pancreatic parenchymal phase. So the left hand side screen is the delayed arterial phase, whereas the right hand side screen is the portal venous phase. So these are the three phases of pancreas protocol for this patient. Now why delayed arterial is the pancreatic parenchymal phase? Because if you can compare the pancreas here and here, the pancreas is very nicely enhanced in the delayed arterial phase, right? You can see this black structure is the pancreatic duct. It is the dilated pancreatic duct, and this is again seen here, but not as well because the pancreatic parenchyma has started to wash out, right? So parenchymal phase is when you can see the pancreas very well. Another important point here is that the tail is not atrophied that much. The duct is dilated, right? And the calcification you can continue seeing in this phase as well, right? This is a ductal stone. But if you can see the pancreatic enhancement, it is better here compared to here. Now, how we know if the pancreas is enhancing? You have to do is you have to compare the body of the pancreas with the paraspinal muscles, and usually the pancreas are more white compared to paraspinal muscles. That means that they are enhancing. If the pattern of pancreas or the color of pancreas is less than paraspinal musculature, then you are seeing a pancreas that is not enhancing, and that may be seen in acute pancreatitis, right? So now this is one more patient, and I am not showing the plain image of this patient, but as before I am showing the delayed arterial phase. You can see the arteries enhancing well here, and the portal venous phase, you can see the portal vein enhancing well here compared to this one, right? So portal venous phase on your right and the delayed arterial phase on your left. Why delayed arterial phase is the pancreatic parenchymal phase? See the nice enhancement of pancreas compared to paraspinal muscles in the delayed arterial phase, whereas it is not enhancing at much in the portal venous phase, right? So this case is important because as you see, this patient had a tumor, and I'll just scroll the console once, and I would like you to identify the tumor and then I will describe it. I am sure most of you have got the tumor. This is a tumor which you can see only in the arterial phase. So this, if you can make out, in two phases. That is why you should see different phases together, right? So this is the pancreas and this is the tumor seen in the arterial phase, but it is washing out in the portal venous phase, and in all probabilities this is a characteristic of a neuroendocrine neoplasm. So this is one of our patients where we did a central pancreatectomy, and you can see a neuroendocrine neoplasm, and this is a tumor which you will see very well in the arterial phase, but it will wash out in the portal venous phase, right? So when the portal vein is enhancing, the tumor has already released the contrast from it. That is why it is not enhancing, because neuroendocrine neoplasms, which are well differentiated, are predominantly supplied by the arteries, right? So it has an arterial supply, and that is why pancreatic neuroendocrine neoplasm is one of the scan that you need to see in the arterial phase, right? However, when you want to study these tumors relation to the vein, you need the portal venous phase. You can see here, this is the tumor area, and there is a nice black lining between the tumor and the vein. So this is a resectable tumor, right? We will see details of this when we discuss the pancreatic tumor, but I am sure this highlights the importance of different phases of pancreas protocol. One more scan. So this is the last scan that we are going to see on the console today. So now again, when you can see, now by now I am sure you already know, as I am moving the console, that the right is the portal venous phase and the left is the arterial phase, right? You can see some air here. So this is a biliary stent. This is a biliary stent. The pancreas, right? As you can see the pancreas, when you compare the enhancement, this area is not enhancing as much, right? This entire area. So this is the pancreas, this is the pancreatic duct, nodal masses, but this is the area which is not enhancing, and that is the area which is causing the tumor, right? So normal pancreatic tumors are not as enhancing as the pancreas because they have very low vascularity. So you can see non-enhancing or hypo-enhancing areas in the pancreas if it is a classical pancreatic adenocarcinoma, right? Again, you can see in the portal venous phase. And in this phase, what is important is to study the relation of the tumor with the portal vein. As you can see, the disease is very close to the portal vein as well as the artery. This is a locally advanced pancreatic cancer in this area. Again, out of context, but if you have noticed, there is a lesion in liver. As I mentioned in the slide, the lesions in liver from pancreas are well visualized in the portal venous phase, right? So you can see something here, but you can't see it here. Again, the benefit of seeing the scan on console, that is a small liver metastasis from the tumor. Thus, to summarize my two key points of this presentation, the first is that always correlate clinically, that is always have a discussion with your radiologist when you are advising a scan so that a proper protocol scan is done and unwanted imaging is avoided. This reduces the radiation related damage, the cost of care goes down, and the delay in diagnosis also goes down. Radiologists, always discuss with your referring doctor and try to identify what they are looking for in the scan so that you can do appropriate scan. So this correlate clinically term applies to both the doctor who is prescribing the scan and the radiologist who is going to do the scan. There has to be a discussion to avoid unwanted imaging. And a pancreas protocol CT as was requested by one of our viewers. So now I hope you are very clear on the CT pancreas protocol. It includes a pre-contrast phase, a delayed arterial phase or the pancreatic parenchymal phase, and the portal venous phase, Occasionally, you can have four phases, where the second phase is early arterial phase or an angiogram. And these are the different findings that you can see in the pancreas protocol. We have already seen some of them in the console examples, but we will study them in detail for each different pathology in upcoming videos. Stay tuned and subscribe to our channel to avoid missing these videos and keep suggesting such interesting topics. Thank you.